In 1940, a group of friends from the Taylor Pond Yacht Club wanted something to do during the winter when they couldn't sail. The group consisted of 10 men and 10 women. They decided that it would be fun to perform a play. The lead member of the group was Dorothy Bierce. She later married and became Dorothy Bierce Eichhorn. Dorothy and the group decided that they were going to put on the play Ladies of the Jury. Their problem was that none of them knew how to direct a play, so they hired the local high school's drama teacher to direct it for them. Eleanor McHugh was the director of Ladies of the Jury. She loved that the community was coming together to show off local talent and wanted to help. Ladies of the Jury was presented on May 19, 1941, in the Edward Little High School Auditorium for family and friends. Here's what happened that first night.
After a moderate turnout at the first production, Ladies of the Jury, at Central School, someone told Mrs. Eichhorn that theater couldn't be done in Lewiston, Auburn. Lewis and Son. May 1st, 1978.
Even though this was said, 48 people signed up to become members of the new organization that night. As time went on, people started realizing that this wasn't just any other theater company. These local thespians were very good. Dorothy Bierce Eichhorn, the founder of Community Little Theater, wanted the group to become bigger and strive for everyone else to want that too. Many people thought the same as Dorothy and started registering for memberships. In the 1950s, a scholarship program was started, offering it to one student from the three local high schools who planned on entering the field of drama or speech. The scholarship would give the students money to pay for their college tuition. The scholarship was named in memory of Roger Eastman, one of the founding members. During these years, memberships were piling in and the theater was getting too small. So the membership bought the Kate J. Anthony House on Turner Street in Lewiston. They called it their clubhouse. This allowed the group to rise above the amateur label that had been placed on them in earlier years. Here's what the paper said about the purchase.
Realizing a dream of long standing, the Community Little Theater Association has acquired its own quarters and members are now tenants at will of property at 102 Turner Street, Auburn, owned by Stanley S. Brown. The association has rented the entire first floor and cellar of the property, which provides space for workshop projects, storing of scenery and costumes, and holding of meetings. Lewis and Son, June 1st, 1950.
The actors at CLT were not paid, but appeared as professionals. The size of the group grew during this time, and the theater needed some form of structure. This led to the first bylaws, and the theater became officially known as the Lewiston Auburn Community Little Theater. The members of CLT would hold Saturday night parties, and many shows were cast on their attendance. The parties were also where positions were set. The first president of CLT was Mr. Grover Eichhorn, the husband of Dorothy Eichhorn. Ticket sales were getting higher during this time, too. CLT offered season tickets, where if you bought your tickets early enough, you were able to pick the seat you wanted. Since the beginning of CLT, not many new directors worked with the group. Eleanor McHugh, who directed the very first show, directed a total of 17 shows at CLT. She was not alone, though. Anne Fostick was one of the first new directors at CLT. She directed 10 shows. Anne was great at teaching aspiring actors the skills necessary to perform, but also not dampening their enthusiasm. A director at CLT only had to meet and adhere to the set of rules and obligations the members set. There were really no specific requirements to become a director. One of the biggest steps for CLT during this time was musicals. CLT had never done a musical before up until the 1955-1956 season. This was the first time that CLT would attempt a musical. The first musical performed by CLT was Kiss Me, Kate. In 1965, word had gotten out that a very good new theater was in Lewiston, Auburn. Memberships grew and a big party was held. The theater continued to grow, which was when many new people started to come and help CLT. Pat Schnitzer was one of these people. She was an active thespian and was glad to help out CLT. She would often borrow, rent, and go scrounging around in thrift shops to dress a cast. 1975 season was a very big one. This was Community Little Theater's 35th anniversary. The first play of their 35th anniversary season was Gypsy. It was CLT's biggest show at the time. The 35th anniversary of CLT meant that a celebration was needed. Here's some information about that celebration.
Included are members and former members of the organization who come from near and far and will be among those who attend the opening night performance of Gypsy. And then we'll go on to a special birthday party at No Tomatoes Restaurant. A special display of photographs, playbills, and other items from throughout the years is now on display at the Auburn Public Library to proclaim Happy 35th Birthday to Lewiston Auburn Community Little Theater Group. Lewis and Daly Sun, April 1st, 1976.
In 1978, a big change happened at CLT. They sold their old clubhouse, the Kate J. Anthony House on Turn Street. The theater moved its home to Central School in Auburn, which was formerly the Edward Little High School. This building then became the Great Falls Art Center. In 1981, Community Little Theater entered an agreement with the Auburn School Department. The agreement allowed the theater to make renovations on the auditorium. The only problem was that they needed to fundraise to get enough money to start the renovations. Here's what Grant Power said about the fundraising for CLT.
This will be followed by a request to quasi-public business leaders and support groups. And finally, a call to members of the general public, including small businesses. We think that we can raise that money without getting into a large conflict with United Way and other fundraising groups in the community, Powers said, adding that Little Theater has never gone to the public for financial help in its 40-year history. The Lewiston Journal, June 10, 1982.
The physical work on the building didn't begin until after the 81-82 season. During the break in between the seasons, they reupholstered the seats, reconstructed the lobby, put up new interior walls, and enlarged the stage and improved lighting and sound. Here's why CLT decided to renovate.
This agreement was sought out by the Community Little Theater because of two issues with which the organization was faced. One issue was the need to dispose of the old clubhouse. The quarters of the clubhouse were cramped, and the rising costs of maintenance and fuel were taking a toll on the treasury. The second issue was the need for a more modern theater. Lewis and Auburn Community Little Theater webpage, 2012.
Starting in August 2011, CLT signed a 99-year lease with the City of Auburn. They would pay $1 per year for 99 years. Immediate plans for the theater are to demolish the West Wing and start interior renovations. These are very difficult negotiations, but as a result, CLT is now in charge of its home and future.
I feel the room sway, but the band is playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So, golly gee, fellas, have a little faith in me, fellas. Golly, never go away, promise you never go away. Golly, never go away again.
Future is bright for CLT. Here's what many board and production board members think about the future of CLT.
I can only see positive things happening for CLT in light of all the recent changes. Owning the space allows the theater to make necessary improvements and renovations for the betterment of the theater. There are obvious changes like more parking for our patrons and space throughout the building for scenery, costumes, building sets, and rehearsals. I think the most important thing about the process is that the theater and the family we've built get to stay in its home, and the tradition of the CLT
the community can
come and enjoy quality live theater. Vincent Rassavon, May 17th, 2012.
As the drama advisor at EL, I am looking forward to our drama club's relationship with CLT. Debbie Bishop, May 23rd, 2012.
In my opinion, every great city in the world has had at its core a strong appreciation for the arts. Until recently, that appreciation appears to have been lacking by Auburn City Council. But now it appears that new value is being placed on the arts with the passing of the Great Falls Center for the Performing Arts to Community Little Theater. With cause for great celebration, it seems that CLT will be the center of the resurgence of the arts in the city of Auburn. Phil Vampatella, May 23rd, 2012. The future of our theaters is both promising but challenging in many aspects. All the possibilities for growth to enhance the experience of theater for our patrons is achievable if all stakeholders become impassioned and vigilant with its achievement. As one of the theater's stakeholders, I'm prepared and excited about the giving of my time and effort to ensure the growth of our theater. Richard Martin, May 25th, 2012.
CLT has touched the hearts of many. Here's thoughts from some people who have been involved with CLT and what it has meant to them.
For me personally, associating myself with CLT has been a godsend. Retirement from airline flying looked pretty boring until I found an outlet that not only keeps me busy, but also keeps me feeling young. It gives me a feeling of accomplishment that I fear I might not otherwise have had. Phil Van Patella, May 23rd, 2012.
Over the years, my family and I have enjoyed many shows at CLT, both plays and also performances staged by other community and school groups. I have always loved the space itself for its ambience and historical value, and am thrilled to be a part of the production team of such a fine venue. Having begun volunteering at the height of the turmoil over Great Falls School, I have been delighted to discover that others in the Auburn-Lewiston area are as interested as I am in preserving the building and the theater. It seems as though the whole community is watching CLT to see what will be made of the space. And, from conversations I have heard among people involved in CLT, many exciting ideas are being discussed to keep Community Little Theater an active and vibrant part of Lewiston and Auburn. Carol Hodgkin, May 23rd, 2012.
CLT has meant so many things to me over the years, the first and closest to my heart being a home away from home. I remember being in high school and all my best friends would do the summer shows at CLT. Instead of spending our time at the beach or going on vacation, we dedicated our summers to the theater and our love for the arts. I was always auditioning for every show I could. CLT has always been a family environment, and I think that's why I still come back to this day. It is my home theater. All my creative family and friends, a place full of memories that can never be replaced. Vincent Rassavon, May 17th, 2012.
I was in my first of many musicals because of CLT and made some wonderful friendships. Because of my involvement, I was asked to help assist in the musical productions at EL, which expanded my knowledge even more and led to my current position as drama advisor and one-act director. Debbie Bishop, May 23rd, 2012. Happiness is the continuation of an ever-growing community theater that is loved by all.